Hi, I'm Satish, Application Engineer for Power Solutions at Tektronix. In this video, I'm going to talk about our TDR measurement and analysis application available on our 4, 5 and 6 Series P MSO oscilloscopes. Time domain reflectometry can be extremely useful for debugging and characterizing the impedance of power distribution networks, PCBs, data buses, cables and interconnects. Tektronix has a long history with TDR technology with sampling oscilloscopes. Sampling scopes continue to be a cost-effective solution but are not as widely available as real-time oscilloscopes, especially when it comes to everyday design and debug. So we now offer the TDR measurement capability on our versatile 4, 5 and 6 Series B MSOs. The 6 Series is available with up to 10 GHz of acquisition bandwidth. Here, I have a 6 Series MSO scope with a J2154A perfect pulse differential step generator from PicoTest. The J2154A is powered by USB. In this demonstration, we will use single-ended measurement, but the J2154A and TDR measurement software can also be used for differential TDR. The pulsar has a built-in divider. The signal divides into two paths, one directly going to the scope and another going to the device under test. Any reflections from the DUT are superimposed on the signal being measured by the scope. For the first few measurements, I will be using P2105A single-ended 50 ohm TDR probe, also from PicoTest. Let us now talk about the TDR measurement on the scope. You can invoke the TDR measurement from the timing measurement group. Let me add the measurement. You will notice a few settings here. You can choose either single-ended or differential measurement. The reflection coefficient or the raw waveform can be turned on or off. And the single-click TDR preset does both TDR auto set and a calibration as well. Let me do the TDR preset now. To calibrate the measurement system, I am keeping the far end of the cable or probe open. As I click on TDR preset, the software automatically sets the horizontal, vertical and trigger settings to capture the first reflection from the DUT. During the preset operation, the software automatically measures the low level, high level and the step amplitudes of the signal and decides compensation factors for the raw waveform and also adjusts the signal accordingly. With one click, the system is calibrated for an open, short and load using the single waveform. Now I am ready to make the TDR measurements on my DUT. Notice that the impedance waveform has been automatically calculated and displayed. I will connect the signal to the TP2 test point on my demo port. You can see a flat 50 ohm trace here. Impedance is very stable across the entire trace. The measurement badge on the right shows the average impedance value of 50.3 ohms. Now, I will connect the board to the TP4 test point. You can observe the impedance variations across the board. The wider PCB trace in the center reduces the impedance value. Now, I will connect the probe to the TP6 test point. You can see that there are two dips due to two wide spots in the trace. You can easily find the distance between those two discontinuities by measuring the timing difference between them and using the dielectric constant of the board. You can also measure the inductance and capacitance values using TDR. Now we will see how to measure the series inductance mounted on my board. A 2 nanohenry series inductor is about halfway along the trace. I will connect the board to the step generator. When I connect the pulsar to the trace with the series inductor, you will notice the blip in the impedance trace. I can use the cursors to integrate the area across the blip to measure the inductance value easily. I am reading around 2.1 nanohenry, which is what I am expecting. Now I will switch the pulsar to the trace with 1 picofarad shunt capacitor. Similarly, I can use the measurement to gate the cursor to measure the shunt capacitance value by integrating the impedance profile. I am reading around 1 picofarad, which is about right. By adding TDR measurements and analysis to your 4, 5 and 6 series MSO, you will be able to debug and characterize the impedance of power distribution networks, PCBs, data buses, cables and interconnects. One-click calibration, automatic calculations and impedance, inductance and capacitance measurements make it easy to get quick insights into your designs.